Hey all, it's Juha from Ellie. Today I'm going to be talking to you about a difference between conceptual and logical models. Now, usually in this business we consider that there are three types of models, right? So you have your conceptual models, you have your logical models, and you have your physical models. The physical models are kind of obvious, so it's about your database and what does it actually look like, how you create that particular database for that particular technology. So we're not going to be talking about that today. Instead, we'll focus on the interesting parts, which are the conceptual and logical models. Now, this is a gray area to many people, and if you follow the discussion, to follow the literature around these topics, people tend to mix these terms quite a lot. They might be confusing one thing for another, or even using these words interchangeably in some cases. What I'm trying to tell you here is that we at Ellie see this in a particular way, which we have also seen to be very beneficial for many kinds of data projects. So consider the conceptual model, which you could also call a business model or a semantical model if you'd like. We see it in a way that it's a description of the business. So what you are basically modeling is the core things that your business is interested in, the things that happen in real world. You have customers, you have invoices, you have products, and all these interact. You want to capture that interaction in the conceptual data model. So it's completely independent of any sorts of technological systems, solutions, projects, anything. You scope it in a specific way, so this is the slice of reality I'm interested in, and then you model the entities and interactions between them. The conceptual model, if defined in such a way, is interesting because it's valid no matter your project. So it's always going to be valuable. Once you've defined that, okay, this is my invoicing data area and this is what it looks like, it's always going to be valid. Unless, of course, your business processes change drastically. Now compare that with the logical model. The approach that we take to logical modeling is that a logical model is basically an implementation design for a specific use case. You have some sort of a use case. It could be self-service analytics, it could be reporting, it could be advanced analytics like data science stuff, whatever that might be. And you want to structure your data in a way that supports that particular use case. So basically what you do is you take the conceptual model, look at it, and try to formulate that in a form that fits the particular use case you have in mind. So it's basically it's implementation design. You're going more into details, you add all the attributes, you add primary and foreign keys and whatnot, and you kind of lose a little bit. It's no longer as easily readable and understandable, and the most important thing, it's no longer valid across all the projects because you're focusing on a specific use case. So the overall idea here is that on the conceptual modeling side, you talk about entities and interactions, associations that they have to do with a particular slice of reality, and on the logical modeling side, you're considering a specific use case and the structures needed for that. You add more detail, you go deeper, but you also lose some of the easy understandability and the communication aspects that you have on the conceptual modeling side. And that's why you kind of need these both. The important thing here is, and this is something that we try to cover with Ellie the tool, is that you need to be able to link these two together. So in your logical model, if you have a fact table or something like that, you have to be able to tell what is it about. And in Ellie, that is actually something that you can do. So you can link the logical entity that this is actually about sales orders, which might be a term defined in your business clause. So in the grand scheme of things, what you should end up with are a limited amount of conceptual models describing the reality as it is, and a larger amount of logical models describing specific structures for specific use cases. That's how we approach logical and conceptual models here at Ellie. I hope this helps. See you again soon.